The SpaceX Starhopper is still waiting for its 200-meter flight, but why does the FAA keep issuing NOTAMs for it? Talking about that, coming up. Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon. If you're new to the channel, we fly high-altitude weather balloon flights to the edge of space and back, and along the way, we talk about space, science, and technology. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing. Today, we're talking about the SpaceX Starhopper and what's up with all those FAA NOTAMs with no actual flight. To bring you up to date, the SpaceX Starhopper is the first step in SpaceX's development of their much larger Starship and Super Heavy rockets, which is intended to take people to the moon and Mars. The Starhopper has completed 3 test flights so far. The first 2 were pretty small, just a couple of centimeters, and the third one was a little bit larger, was about 59 feet or 18 meters. Now they currently have a 4th and final test flight scheduled to go to about 200 meters or about 650 feet, but that has yet to take place. After that 4th and final test flight, SpaceX will move on to their orbital prototype for much larger test flights. Now, SpaceX doesn't really publicize when their test flights are gonna be, but one of the ways SpaceX fans keep tabs on this is by keeping an eye on beach closures and road closures, as well as looking at the FAA's website for NOTAMs. Now, this is where things get a little bit confusing because there have been several NOTAMs issued so far. One was on August 16th to the 18th, one was for August 21st to the 23rd, and now there's a new one for August 26th, but with all those NOTAMs being issued, we haven't yet had a test flight. Furthermore, Elon Musk has mentioned on Twitter that the FAA still has not issued approval for their flight. So why, if the FAA has not issued approval, is the FAA actually publishing NOTAMs? Well, to understand this, first we gotta understand what a NOTAM is. NOTAM is an abbreviation for a notice to airmen. These are the notifications that they publish for pilots and air traffic controllers to review prior to flights. NOTAMs cover a whole range of activity, from hazardous flight conditions to just unusual activity. In the case of SpaceX, they're issuing a TFR, or a temporary flight restriction. Essentially, this is telling pilots, don't fly here. It's for your own safety. Some of the other NOTAMs that can be issued are for airport operations, like taxiways that are closed, or runways that are closed, or maybe lights that are not operational. We also issue NOTAMs for all of our high-altitude weather balloon flights. Actually, we issue 8. Just for one flight. Lockheed Martin is the government contractor that is responsible for handling the NOTAM system. They ensure through Leidos Flight Services that NOTAMs have the proper formatting and that they're actually published for people to view. It's actually pretty easy to issue a NOTAM. All you have to do is just call the Lockheed Martin hotline.
Welcome to the Leidos Outage Reporting and Notice to Airmen line.
Hi, this is Tori from Overlook Horizon. I'm looking to file a NOTAM for a unmanned high-altitude balloon.
Can I ask the identifier for the closest airport or VOR?
India Uniform Alpha.
And do you have a fixed radial distance?
Distance is going to be at 358 degrees at 005 nautical miles.
And then what day are you guys going to be flying this balloon?
This is going to be on August 26th at 1400 Zulu.
And I do have your NOTAM number if you're ready.
Go ahead.
India Uniform Alpha 08/555.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Have a great day.
A notice to airmen is in no way an approval from the FAA. Many of the federal aviation regulations require NOTAMs to be published. For issues that surround a specific event, like a balloon launch or a rocket launch, a lot of times those regulations require that NOTAMs be in place ahead of time. For our balloon launches, we're required to have a NOTAM in place between 6 and 24 hours before launch, but it's pretty common for bigger events where the NOTAMs are required to be in place 1 to 3 days prior to the event. So ultimately what we're seeing here is SpaceX trying to get ahead of the game and publishing their NOTAMs early so that they can be ready to fly as soon as they do get their approval. What SpaceX is actually waiting for is their safety approval, which comes from the FAA's Office of Commercial Space Transportation. Even more specifically, Elon Musk has said on Twitter that the FAA is looking for SpaceX to do some additional hazard analysis before they will grant that approval. This is where they determine all the possible things that could go wrong, what the probability is that they will go wrong, if they do go wrong, how big of a hazard is it to public safety, and what steps has SpaceX taken to minimize the risk or add redundant systems. You may be familiar with one of the main ways that SpaceX deals with that on their Falcon 9 rocket, which is through their Autonomous Flight Termination System, or AFTS.
AFTS is ready for launch.
This system immediately terminates the flight if it detects that something is a little bit off. On the SpaceX webcast, we frequently hear,
AFTS is saved.
Which essentially means that the AFTS has been turned off when the launch vehicle is no longer a risk to public safety. Now, this additional hazard analysis that the FAA is waiting for from SpaceX sounds to me like they are either waiting for additional documentation for some tests that SpaceX did to support their hazard analysis, or the FAA may be wanting SpaceX to do additional tests and feel that the test data that SpaceX has provided them so far is not enough to address their safety concerns. Remember that this is a much larger 200 meter hop, which means that there's a lot more fuel in it and that rocket can get a lot farther and do a lot more damage if there's some sort of catastrophic uncontrolled failure. Hopefully it'll be a quick and easy process for SpaceX to get the documentation necessary to the FAA so they can get that approval and we can all see the Starhopper fly on Monday. So question of the day is, do you think the Starhopper will fly on Monday? It feels like we've been waiting forever, but I think there might be a chance. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. As always, thanks to our Patreon supporters for making videos like this possible. If you like this kind of content, please like the video and consider subscribing so we can connect. All right, thanks everybody for watching. We'll see you in the next video.